So Unite Copenhagen just got wrapped up, and that means that Unity held their official keynote as well as a roadmap talk on their plans for the future. Luckily, we got to participate, so here's what's coming to Unity in 2020. But first, this video is sponsored by Senva Academy. If you've ever thought about creating an RPG, I really recommend you go check out their RPG Academy. Featuring 13 complete courses containing 29 hours of on-demand content, it covers everything from coding basics to customizing avatars, turn-based battle systems, map and quest systems, procedurally generated dungeons, and much more. Senva is an authorized Unity partner, and RPG Academy has been extensively reviewed and authorized by Unity themselves. With a one-time payment, you get access to course videos, project files, PDF notes, offline access, and in-course support by expert instructors, and by using the coupon code Brackeys, you get 15% off. Simply click the link in the description to get started. Also, special thanks to Infinity PBR for his support on Patreon. Now let's start with the keynote. Here Lucas jumped right into the deep end by showing off some improvements to dots, specifically in terms of making it easier to read and code for. Remember, dots is just a word for ECS, the C# drop system, and burst combined. And if you don't understand what that is, that's totally fine. Just remember that whenever we are saying dots, what we're really referring to is just a new technology that is kind of a new way of thinking about how to code in Unity that is also insanely much faster than the old one. After that, Joachim came on stage, for some reason not wearing a pink shirt. Anyway, he started off by showing some editor improvements that automatically convert game objects to runtime optimized entities. As you can see, we now have a preview of this in the inspector that updates automatically to any changes that we make on the game object. He then went on to show an FPS sample project built on top of dots. And I think this was a really big step, because it's the first time that we're seeing a project that nicely combines all these different engine features built specifically for dots. It's using the new Unity physics, which are made for dots, and it's running on the new FPS netcode, which is also made for dots. According to Joachim, the new netcode makes it easy to build solid multiplayer FPS games, and it has features like client-side prediction, lag compensation, and interpolation all built in. The project also uses the new Unity animation package, again, of course, built for dots, and notice how they're using IKs to adjust the position of the feet to the environment. Pretty cool. And the best thing is that the project is built with the purpose of being easy to understand. And I think that's really important because I think a lot of people, myself included, still have many unanswered questions when it comes to dots. And right when it couldn't get much more exciting, they showed off Live Link. With Live Link, you can make changes to your built games from inside the Unity editor at runtime. This is incredibly useful, and it's going to speed up my development process so much, especially when working on multiplayer games where you often have many clients running at the same time. Now all of this is shipping as preview packages in 2019.3. They also showed off some of the 2D tools. Now a lot of it we've definitely seen before, however I was really excited to see dynamic 2D shadows. Of course they in general just showed a lot of cool stuff coming in the next version of Unity 2019.3, but I'm going to save most of this for a What's New video dedicated to going over the new version. In this video I want to focus on what we can expect to see in the coming year, cause there's a lot. Finally, in the keynote, they of course showed off the continuation of the Heretic demo, and it was really, really cool. Now this year Unite actually took place in our home city Copenhagen, which meant that we got to take part in all the fun activities and events that Unity were hosting that week. We had some roundtable meetings with Unity, which were extremely productive and fun, and we had some dinners where we got to meet a lot of awesome people. In general, it was just a lot of fun meeting other content creators who were there, and of course just hanging out in the expo hall. And now what we've all been waiting for? The roadmap talk, which did definitely not disappoint. So first of all, the asset pipeline is being rebuilt to be much faster, including on-demand import where assets are imported only as you need them. This should eliminate a lot of the load time when opening new projects. I'm just curious to see if it leads to any wait times in the editor itself. And talking about the editor, we're going to see major speed improvements in 2020.1. Finally, selecting large quantities of objects will be a breeze. This is something that I could definitely have used when creating our Unity stress test videos, so it's nice to see that it's being worked on. In terms of graphics, 2D light and shadows should be production ready in 20.2, with experimental soft shadows coming in 20.1. Along with that is an eye shader for HDRP and a deferred renderer for URP. That's right, the lightweight render pipeline is being renamed to Universal Render Pipeline. Definitely a more suiting name considering Unity is working towards making this the standard renderer. Sometime in 2020, we will also be getting visual texturing or texture streaming. This is a performance optimization where Unity takes a high quality texture, chops it up into little bits, and effectively only renders the parts that the player is seeing. Think of it like occlusion culling for textures. Pretty cool. In 2020.1, the audio engine is also being rebuilt for dots, and we will be able to enter prefab mode in the context of the scene. Entities is also becoming production ready. Why this isn't called dots here, I have no idea. And of course, you can't have a roadmap talk without mentioning visual scripting. Luckily, we are getting close with a promised preview in 20.1. It seems to be built with non-programmers in mind, which I definitely think it should, but it also has support for custom nodes, which the programmer in me really likes. Of course, we could talk about visual scripting forever, and we're definitely going to be making lots of content on it, but until then, here are some of the features that we can expect. In 2019.3, we are also getting a full editor redesign. I'll definitely be going into more detail on this in our What's New video, but something that I'm really glad to hear is that Unity has plans for bringing more tools into the scene view in 2020. This is so incredibly needed in terms of making some of these creative packages like Terrain, Tilemap, ProGrids, and ProBuilder feel more integrated with the editor. And talking about UI, in 2020 Unity is bringing UI elements to the runtime as well. UI elements is a way to build UI using CSS-like styling. It includes a new UI builder, and I definitely see why this is an improvement for the editor, but I'm really curious as to how this is going to work together with the current UI system. Are they going to work alongside each other? When are we going to use what? I don't know, but I'm pretty excited to find out. In terms of animation, we are getting a lot of updates in 20.1, including freeform animation, which allows you to modify bone-based animation and even edit motion capture data. Basically, it just looks like a huge update to working with rigged characters in Unity. On top of that, Kinematica, the AI-based animation system, is being released in preview. Moving on, I'm still excited for Quick Search, which is currently available as a package and will hopefully soon be integrated with the editor. And in 20.1, the Package Manager can now be used to directly publish to the Asset Store. It's nice to see these two systems start to be merged in a meaningful way. At this point in the roadmap, Will went on to talk about the Environment System. Not the Terrain System, the Environment System. Now I'm going to be totally honest here and admit that I have no idea what that is. Neither does anyone else, it seems. But apparently it allows you to build terrain by combining game objects in a layer-like structure. What exactly that means, I'm not totally sure, but I'm definitely intrigued. Project Tiny is scheduled for 2020 with no specific date in sight. However, Unity is working on bringing 3D to Project Tiny, which is pretty cool. Now, a really big feature that is coming already later this year is the Unity Distribution Portal. This basically enables you to distribute your game to a bunch of different stores using a single hub, which just sounds like such a quality of life improvement. And finally, in terms of networking, we're getting .NET Code in 20.1. Dots, netcode, networking, woo, multiplayer, yeah! In the beginning, it's a simple framework mainly focused on server authoritative architecture, but Unity will be expanding on this later to provide other netcode solutions for other types of games like fighting games, strategy games, and so on. What I'm mainly curious about is, first of all, how easy is this going to be to use, and how is this going to be implemented into the editor? Is it going to be just programming, or are we going to see a component-based approach like we did with UNet for helping people quickly set up basic multiplayer functionality? I guess time will tell. We can also expect to see multiplayer matchmaking later this year with flexible matchmaking for multiplayer games, latency matching, as well as backfill. In the first quarter of 2020, they're also adding support for parties and lobbies, which is great. Now that's pretty much all the features we could squeeze into this video. If you want to learn more, we'll have a link to the keynote as well as the roadmap talk in the description. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell so you don't miss the next one. Also, don't forget to check out Zenva Academy and their RPG curriculum. Simply click the link in the description and use coupon code Brackeys to get 15% off. Phew, that was all the features. On that, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video. Thanks to all of the awesome Patreon supporters who donated in September, and a special thanks to Kirill Svidersky, Infinity PBR, Dennis Sullivan, Peter Schrendiman, Lost to Violence Loved Forever, Chris, Faisal Marify, Leo Lissette, Runin, Daniel Dosanik, Steve Christensen, Jacob Stanford, Naoki Wasaki, Gregory Pierce, The Mighty Zeus, Edison the Fierce, and Erasmus. You guys rock.